Queen Bee. Inviting her friends that lived in town. She gave her friends a buzz on the phone as she sat down on her beautiful throne.
The flies were her first invited guests. After all, they were cute little pets.
Where's he at? Don't break the flashlight.
After the song, all the flies flew around except one fly who fell to the ground. The fly that fell down in great pain struggled to get up and tried to explain. I started a fight with fearless flies. As I took the first swing, I lost and ended up with a broken wing.
I hope you have learned your lesson not to fight. In the future, you should be more polite. So stop trying to be so tough. Be off with you. I've heard enough.
Next came the ladybugs, the small beetles with their spotted backs, who feed on insects and their eggs, and those are the facts.
I
read. Queen Bee asked, "What happened?" And this is what she said. "One day I went sailing in the middle of the ocean when I realized I had forgotten my lotion. When I finally got back to shore, I was all red and sunburned and sore. I suffered from first-degree burns from the sun. It was an emergency, so I dialed 911. Mrs. Queen Bee looked at her, hoping that she had learned her lesson. What she was asked was totally out of the question.
Then came the fireflies, the winged bugs, the winged beetles, which acted that night. Their abdomens glowed with a luminescent light.
That one bug did not seem to glow. She asked him why, as she wanted to know.
"I cannot glow. I've lost my light. It hasn't been easy for me. Now I wear glasses to see."
You should learn to keep better track of your things. Next thing you know, you'll be losing your wings.
She invited the spiders who are not part of the bug society. However, adopting arachnids would add a nice variety.
Thank you.
spider who was totally unmatched. She couldn't tell he had something he had to inspect.
I decided to give another spider a push wall on a brick wall, but unfortunately I lost my balance and I took a fall. I then tried to call up the water spout. Down came the rain and I lost one leg about. I have 7 legs now. I'm minus 1. Getting along these days isn't much fun. What's worse is my slow leg fall. I can't even skim a spumpet at all.
You must really learn to be more kind. With those kind of manners, you're no friend of mine.
Buzzing, buzzing around the trees. Next on the list, the honeybee.
You might be contagious. This whole matter is strictly outrageous.
The little bee was certainly a total disgrace, and Mrs. Queen Bee simply said, "Get out of this place."
That little bee made a beeline out the door, realizing the bee couldn't take it anymore. Last call, we are the bugs who like to socialize. Of course, we're referring to the butterflies.
Thank you.
noticed one bug without wings. It was the color green. It was the strangest bug she has ever seen.
I was told by Professor Bug that I wouldn't turn into a butterfly until June. But did I listen? I'm still a caterpillar. I came out too soon. Now everyone views me as being premature, and that certainly can make a bug feel very insecure.
You better make it your top priority to listen to authority. You must go through four stages: the egg, the larva, the pupa, and the butterfly. Being the final result, it's obvious you never left the larva stage and became an adult.
At this point, Mrs. Queen Bee decided to name her uninvited guest mischievous. After all, most of them had done something a little devious.
The list was now complete. She ordered her guest to take a seat.
We are
Sure enough, the termites began eating the tree. The mischievous bugs must go warn Queen Bee. Queen Bee ignored them and began to shout, "Don't bug me and please get out." At that moment, the tree began to sway. Would the bugs survive until the next day? Miss Queen Bee saw termites eating wood. By turning to the bugs, she now understood.
Bugs returned to the hive, glad to see all the guests still alive. As the bugs began to spray, the termites started to run. Finally, the termites left the scene one by one. Luckily, the bugs left the hive and went on the scene with a can of spray to save the day.
Queen Bee approached the bugs, out of breath, "You'd feel the same if you were near death."
At this point, she began to feel sorry for a time she had been mean. She also felt the need to tell the truth, for she was not a queen.